you mentioned, just bringing the energy and getting the fans up, you know, giving them the win that they deserve. You know, they showed out really well, especially against Florida State. Really brought all the energy, really loud, and helped us out a ton. So, you know, we're very prideful in winning in Death Valley and, you know, giving the fans what they deserve, especially, you know, with just how much they've put into us this season as well. Relationships. So yeah, it's been great though. And you know, in terms of, you know, going out there and competing, kind of having to shift our mindset from, you know, the original goal that we had set out to achieve. I think it's been really good how the teams responded, how I've responded personally. And you know, that's one thing that's easy for me. It's just my competitive nature. You know, it'll never allow me to, you know, take something off whether I want to or not, whether, you know, it's tough to get up and maybe have the same motivation. You know, my competitive nature is driven by discipline, so that always helps me out. And I think that the team, in terms of them, they've also done a tremendous job with just, you know, how we've responded and, you know, kind of the mindset going forward. Yes, there's no doubt about that. You know, I think, you know, when adversity hits, you know, there's two directions you can go. You can kind of shy away from it, or you can, you know, just go straight at it and use it as a learning opportunity. And, you know, that's what we've done. You know, like I said, it's not easy to shift your mindset when you work for something all off season and it's kind of taken off the table. So, you know, just being able to shift that mindset and, you know, use the adversity at hand for an opportunity to get better, to get closer, which is, you know, exactly what we've done. Yeah, I think the chemistry of this football team is you know, amazing and something that I love to be a part of every day. And I've seen the joy and the excitement, you know, even the past 2 weeks. It's just how we've prepared, how we've done everything. So, yeah, I think that, you know, the adversity has shined us up, not grinded us up. Yeah, no doubt. You know, I think towards the end of that game, you know, we had opportunities to put them away, no question. I think just having Phil and I and being able to bounce off one another, whether it's the two-back set or, you know, whether it's getting a little bit of rest while the counterpart goes out there and does their work is huge for us. And obviously wanted to put them away late in the game when we had the opportunities to, but we didn't. So, you know, just continuing to look at how Phil and I can help this football team, help this offense in particular, and just keep doing our thing. I think it'll definitely play a factor. I think just with how this football team is, you know, with Cade not having a ton of experience, just, you know, starting in too many football games, it being his first year, you know, teams wanted to see that, you know, he could beat them through the air. And you know, you saw that in the game plans, how they've been defending us. And you know, as Cade has proven that, you know, he's got the ability to throw the ball. We've got the receivers, the guys that can go make the plays. Teams, you know, can't just guard us like we're one-dimensional. I think it'll open up a ton of things for Phil and I. You know, if they got to choose one or the other, then that puts us in a really good position. So just got to continue to flourish and do well, you know, in both parts, in the passing game and the running game, and just make defenses choose, you know, choose which one they want to try to stop. Just as you mentioned, the big plays that he's making, I think he's just learning from every opportunity and every mistake that he's made. He's learned from it, and you know, that's when the game truly slows down. Is when you're able to view it as, you know, just going out there and it being just like the practice field, and that's kind of the shift that I've seen in Cade's mind, just his ability to manage the game and the plays that he's making. I mean, some of the times where he had to, you know, tuck it and run on third down, kept his eyes up, hit Tyler Brown downfield a couple times. I mean, those are, you know, plays that can win you a football game. And he's starting to make them. He's starting to kind of just blossom and just continuing to get better every week, which is exactly what we thought would happen with Cade. But yeah, he's never turned down an opportunity to learn from a mistake, you know, to even learn from a success or, you know, a good play. There's always things that he's tweaking and always trying to get better, which is why he's going to be great for sure. Yeah, we've got all-time confidence, you know, in this offense, and you know, there's never a time when we've lacked belief in how we can move the ball. You know, if we just make the routine plays and you know, do everything that we do out there on this practice field, you know, nobody has been able to stop us. So, you know, we've got so much confidence in this offense, what we can do, and, you know, just the confidence that we're going to continue to grow and get better. You know, we've gotten better every single week, and you know, that's what you want to see out of not only the team, but, you know, the offense in particular. Yeah, I think that best in the standard applies to everything in your life. So, you know, for me, I have my priorities. You know, God comes first, family second, and then academics, sports, and then my social life. So, you know, not only being best or holding myself to that standard and, you know, the first 3 out of 5 categories, but doing it for every single one. My relationship with God being my first priority, or, you know, my fifth priority, with some of the, you know, relationships that I have off the field, and you know, holding myself to that same standard for each one of those, and you know, giving everything that I got in every aspect of my life, you know, that will allow me to reach my potential and do everything that I want to. And then I think the second one that you mentioned was quest for best. Kind of goes along the same lines, but if you're always pushing to not be the best, but it could be your best, you know, then in return, you're going to get the results and the success that you want. So, you know, that doesn't only apply to the football field. It doesn't only apply to the classroom. It applies to every aspect of your life, because, you know, the deficiencies or the places where you don't emphasize, those will get exposed sometime down the road. You know, and that's a fact. So, yeah, just always trying to be your best in every aspect. You know, like I said, whether it's the first priority or the fifth priority, you just gotta do your best. Yeah, it's something that I've loved to do really ever since I can remember playing football. You know, the Pop Warner days in October when they'd be handing out, you know, pink socks and wristbands, and then just the message behind it.